if somebody were to come to me and say, Brad, in the future, you're going to be meeting the President of the United States and the First Lady, and you're also going to be doing marketing for a $2.2 billion brand, and then on top of that, working with brands like MTV and meeting Kanye West, and I mean, I would have been like, what? No way. But it happened. Just a regular person who overcame extraordinary circumstances. I've been climbing on this marketing journey for 14 years. To the best of my understanding, shaky recollection, the first time I lived was when I truly noticed how powerful our thoughts really are.
Okay, Kanye, you're the new hip-hop hero, man. You're saving souls, and you brought a new style to the game. Have you ever exceeded all your expectations from the music industry?
Yeah, well, it was never about the music industry. It's about the music. And I've definitely accomplished all my dreams, and along the way, I started setting new goals for myself. So we still got some more stuff we want to accomplish.
Now, you got a big album coming out right now. You have a stunning video out called Diamonds from Sierra Leone from the new album about to drop. You shot it in Prague. What made you want to shoot in Prague, the video?
I always wanted to shoot something in Prague because how beautiful the architecture was, and I thought it really matched up well with the sound of the song, how grand the song was. We had to find sculptures and buildings that could somehow match up to it. Yo, what's up? This is kind of Louis Vuitton Don.
Creating the desire is what marketing psychology is all about. When we close our eyes to break the speed of light, to go back in time, to relive the beginning, to recreate the future by re-engineering to get to the destination, dreaming vividly without gravity of a sky ceiling, architecting my brand. If God controlled time and time is pre-decided, I am going to live for this moment. But I was once looking for the same thing. And it went something like this.
This is Damian Fahey, host of MTV's TRL Weekend Countdown here on Jammin' 1420. And here's your local nightclub update with Bradley MacMayer.
You know, TRL has been a major part of MTV and the world of music for the last decade, with a huge impact on pop culture. On Sunday, November 16th at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, Total Request Live, Face to Black. Joining me on the phone right now is a person you know all too well here on our station. He kicks off your weekend on Fridays from 8 to 11, hosting the MTV TRL Top 20 Weekend Countdown. He is also the main host for the TV show. It is the one and only Damian Fahey. What's going on, man?
That was a beautiful introduction. Thank you so much.
Fallout Boy, Beyonce, 50 Cent, Diddy. And is this good? Is this going down like a VMA? Are you guys shutting down Times Square?
Yeah, basically that's what we're going to do. We're going to, if you ever watch New Year's Eve on TV, it's going to be a lot like that. It's going to be me and Carson hosting the show.
One, let's two, go. Three. In the place to be. As it is plain to see. I am. The quest grooving.
And the record breaking.
And the record breaking. Tonight I'm gonna take you on a musical journey.
Sight and sounds, bitch.
Sight and sound.
Let's go. You will learn the key branding principles and branding actions.
Take it down to the house deep. Touchdown.
For years, celebrities, athletes, politicians have understood the power of marketing themselves. You are a miracle. Scientists estimate the probability of you being born is about 1 in 400 trillion.
She was a housekeeper for, at the time, the CEO of Sony Music. And I remember begging her, like, can you please, you know, get in contact with the office and him and see if I could, you know, get an interview, because I really wanted to get into the music industry at the time and I wanted to be doing marketing. And I mean, it was just like one of those things, like, okay, she works for Andrew Lack, who is now, by the way, the chairman of NBC News. He moved on from, you know, working with Sony. But I begged my aunt. So she got me the opportunity to go to the HR department in Sony in New York. So I remember just, you know, being in Manhattan and going to this meeting. And I was so happy. I was elated. The euphoria was like off the chart. And I remember going to the HR, this person's office, and he's like, what do you want to do? So I said, well, I want to, you know, I want to come to New York and I want to be doing marketing for all of the talents in here, and I want to be doing all these events for these talents and working with the promotion department, the managers. And they were like, do you have any experience prior to this? And I really didn't, you know. All I had at the time, it was a dream, the goal, and I, you know, had access, you know, to the CEO of Sony, you know, through my aunt. He gave me an opportunity to get this interview, but I had a marketing background, but I, in the music industry, I didn't have one at the time. So unfortunately, he's like, okay, Brad, this is what I want you to do. Just go back out there and just learn as much as you can about the music industry, and then come back to me in a few years. And then, like, I was like, a few years? I mean, my heart just dropped. I remember leaving that office like in tears. I was like, shit, man, fuck. And, I mean, my heart was shattered. That was like my dream. I really wanted to work for Sony Music. So that didn't happen, but it just created an emotional fire in me to go out there and learn everything. When I say everything, everything that has to do with marketing, with the music industry. It was just one of those things that I'm going to do it. So that's how I began, you know. Getting to the industry, I started out as a radio program director. At the time, I brought in programs like Meet the Press, because, you know, I had a talk show format. So I brought in Meet the Press as a syndicated radio program, MTV Radio at the time, the Laura Ingraham Show, Billy Bush, his syndicated radio show, Larry King Live. So these are all the syndicated radio programs that I was able to bring into the station that I was working for. So I was programming the lineup. I was also hosting a morning radio program, and we had to produce. I was waking up so early. We had to produce a radio show We had to go on the air and do that whole interview with celebrities and talk about the daily news and what's going on in the community. I've learned so much just being on the radio. I was hired to do marketing for the Papa John's brand. That was so much fun. Better ingredients, better pizzas, Papa John's, for sure. And I'm not saying this just because I worked for the Papa John's brand, but they do have the best quality and the best tasting pizza in the world. So with that said, so when I first came in, my first thing that I needed to do, they wanted to move from print to digital. Well, Papa John's all about serving the community. We do a lot of school fundraisers throughout South Florida. We want to give back, and we also want to make sure, you know, these parents, we do fundraisers for them every month. We give 15% back to the schools of any purchase that they make on PapaJohns.com. So I was able to organize that, bring new schools into the fundraiser program, and also expand the technology and also creating websites for that technology as well, because they were doing print at the time to spread the word about the fundraiser. So when I first came in into Papa John's, one of my main things to do was create a system and put a system in place and create a website technology that was gonna get us from going from print to digital. So I did it. We created papafundraisers.com, and we created a website that you were able to go in there, look at your school in the list, and you were able to just click on it, and then we'll take you to papajohns.com. You will place your order, and then once you place your order, you also were able to share online, whether it was Facebook, Twitter, any of the social, any of your favorite social preference, and tell your neighbors and friends that you just placed an order and we're doing a great fundraiser tonight for this school, and it will share on your feed. I was working very closely with the Miami Dolphins, the Miami Heat, the Florida Marlins, because we are official sponsors of their brand. So we also did a lot of work together with a creative agency, Zimmerman, and they did a lot of our media buys. One of the best things that I wanted to do is that I wanted to partner up with Ryan Tannehill and his mini camp that he does every summer with Citibank in South Florida. So I was able to get Papa John's involved in that and get Ryan involved with Papa John's. So it was a great merge of brands right there. And Ryan's a powerhouse brand in South Florida along with his wife and the Miami Dolphins. So it was just a great fit, and to have Papa John's involved with that and just making it all happen, it was amazing. It came out really awesome. I was partnering up with Joe DiMaggio's Children's Hospital, the Humane Society, Make-A-Wish Foundation. That was very important to me because I want to make sure that the Papa John's brand were involved in that specific identities, because we give back. And that's what Papa John's also all about. It's about the community. You see, we as marketers are paid to think, add value, solve problems for others, act and transact business differently and more effectively than anyone else. We make things happen creatively. We can be intuitive, successful. We can have crazy ideas in this space. Unlike when you're in school where you only learn to conform and behave.
Yeah. somebody who is an entrepreneur or a brander is you have found an amazing way to tell a story. That's it. You're telling a new story. You will not create anything new.
Sure. Well, I met Damon John in Orlando. We were doing a morning syndicated show called The Daily Buzz, which is a 140 market syndicated television morning show in Orlando. And, you know, Damien and I were in the green room and we were talking about technology and how technology is advancing and so forth. And he did give me his business card at the time. And then eventually I embarked on board of doing his Facebook branded page along with his team. And then I was in charge of doing the analysis and we're doing posts as well for his marketing campaign. And he, by the way, Damon is a genius. I just want to let everyone know that. But during that time in Orlando, we did also the radio morning shows, radio tours. He was promoting an event he was doing with Cap, the NBA player, during NBA All-Star weekend. So I was invited to Damon's event at nighttime with Kevin. And you know, it was just a blast. Great guy, great company, and I wish him all the best, man. Great, 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 great guy. Now, moving forward, I was able to be involved in an entrepreneurial seminar with my colleague that him and I created called Shark Tour, which involved four of the sharks in the hit TV show NBC, Shark Tank. And so Damon was involved in that, you know, Robert Hershevac was involved in that, Barbara was involved, so, you know, four of the cast members, and it was just, it was gonna be huge.
Hi, I'm Kevin Harrington, one of the original sharks from Shark Tank, the hit show on ABC Network. I want to invite you to come on down to the Shark Tour and Entrepreneur Expo in Orlando on November 2nd. I'm going to be there with a bunch of the other sharks, and this is presented by Bobby Seller.
Hi, this is Robert Hershevac from the ABC hit show Shark Tank. I'm looking forward to seeing you at the Shark Tour and Entrepreneur Expo presented by Bobby Seller.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran from the hit show on ABC Shark Tank, and I'm here to invite you and a few of your friends to come to the Shark Tour and Entrepreneur Expo in Orlando, Florida, presented by Bobby Seller himself.
I'm here with Damon John from ABC's hit show Shark Tank. Damon, welcome.
I'm excited. Thank you for having me. Of course, we're going to do the Shark Tour 2013, right? Business Expo, hosted and presented by my man, Bobby Seller.
There are no rules in marketing, folks. The imagination is just endless. Thoughts become things. Our thoughts have frequency and we have pure energy. When you throw a pebble into the lake, the entire shoreline has changed. In fact, the butterfly effect. The concept that small causes can have large effects. If you throw a pebble into the Atlantic Ocean, the entire shoreline has been altered.
President of the United States, Donald Trump, and the First Lady Melania, it was at Mar-a-Lago at Art for Life. Russell Simmons, you know, who's a pioneer in the hip-hop world. So it was at Mar-a-Lago, Donald Trump's place over there in Palm Beach, and it was just packed. Everyone was there. When you walk into Mar-a-Lago, it's just, I never seen so much gold in my life. I was like, wow, their ballroom is just immaculate. And that's when the time I was like, wow, this guy is just in a totally different world than where we're at. everything with Donald Trump, from what I've seen at his Mar-a-Lago stay, is about detail. I mean, there was even gold in the sink in the bathroom. We were honoring Puff Daddy, P. Diddy, that evening. So Diddy was there, everyone was there. My compliments to the chef at Mar-a-Lago. Just, the food is so delicious. It is just incredible. Working closely with MTV Radio gave me the opportunity to meet Steve LaBelle. So Steve LaBelle's cool. I met him at the MTV Music Awards in New York City. I was managing a talent at the time, and he was managing Sean Kingston, the pop singer.
Legend.
You mean the Magic Johnson?
Yes, the Magic Johnson.
From Lakers?
Irving Magic Johnson. And a couple people got, one person got, you know, groupied out. And
who got groupied out?
Brad.
Oh, Brad got groupied out.
A to Z Radio, online marketing guy got groupied out. But it's okay, that's, you know, that's a legend.
So Steve LaBelle and I hit it off really great. I mean, I already heard a lot about him. So we switched numbers, we kept in contact, and then eventually I was able to, get very close with Steve, and I love that guy to death. But what an amazing mind he's got. So I learned a lot from Steve. But we did a lot of great stuff together too. I was able to do marketing for A to Z Entertainment, which that's his label. All the time, Steve and I, we were able to partner up and manage the talent and Emily Lodato. Keep in mind, Steve was already managing IAS, man, at the time he was blowing up. He had a song, Man I Feel Like Money. It was the song's called Buzzin'. IAS, it was big in the scene, and he just had so much going. And I was working with Emily on the side. I met Emily backstage, and when I first met her, I just knew that she had the looks, the voice, and the charisma. And so Steve and I partnered up together, and we decided to bring Emily into the industry. And she was able to do, acting, and also at the time she was able to do songwriting.
This is man. That's Emily. And this is God, Steve LaBelle.
Steve is here. Brad is here. I'm here. Got Emily on the way. Chase, keep me fly. Getting man ready right now.
For Emily's first track, I made a phone call to Flash from Bone Thugs and Harmony. I said, Flash, you need to do me a favor. Can you hop on this track? Giving up big gang, I got plenty sauce. Flashing bone back, laying down the law. I'm a home boss, pay big dues off. I've been around the world, been there, done that. My heart telling me, get it, I make it run that. I never did hold back. And keeping it real, that's why you folks always vouch for the stack. You know I had to never win for a while. I've been in jail now, so never could let them hold me down. That's why you see me with a smile, instead of frowning. Easy to eat, discovering the journey, gonna found him. Just a winner with them Cleveland and Cali. With all the condition to come up with what happened. Don't hurt, and then leave it out of the way. Emily Lodato was the leading actress in the Man T-Pain video called Get It Girl. There was a lot of product placements into this video. As you can see here, Emily having to hold bottles of vodka in the video and all these visuals.
A new female pop star from Miami, Emily, and I got a couple more tricks up my sleeve. And you know, a day in the life with Steve LaBelle is kind of weird, but exciting. Everybody wants to be next to Steve LaBelle. Everyone wants to be in my position. I'm always traveling in different countries. I could be in India one day, in Hong Kong the next day, and in Vegas the next day. At the Giants game, the Knicks game, could be wherever. You just never know.
Video. Run out of concept of the video, man. You know.
I'm saying? I'm a big dumbass party. It's going backwards. It's a Pulp Fiction party.
Nice. Hey, man, well, how did it all come about as far as the writing, the concept? The song obviously is awesome.
Yeah.
Just a little background.
Basically, man, you know what I'm saying? It's a song about the women doing their thing and getting it.
Come on.
You feel me? And, you know, me and T-Pain hooked up just because, you know, T-Pain is that guy. You know what I'm saying? He's that dude.
Hook up T. Washington.
And I'm that dude. And two dudes, you know, we had to do our thing. You feel me? No homo. You feel me? But we made it. We made it work. You feel me? We got this record, Get It Girl, and it's about to blow up. The ladies love it. Overseas loves it. In America, they love it. The clubs love it. It's going down. You already know.
The strip clubs
especially.
Watch out for the dance. Watch out for the new dance coming with that thing. You better know it.
So, man, had the opportunity to go to the UK and do summer festivals there through ADZ Entertainment and Beluga Heights. Steve LaBelle already knew 50 Cent from Queens, and they were already friends over there. This was behind the scenes with Steve LaBelle, 50 Cent, Man, and the entire ADZ crew, and they were filming Man, I Feel Like Money, the buzzing track for Man.
That's right, Jake. Oh, you know that, Jesse Terrero. We do it real big every time we do it. You know what I mean? We're out here playing around. You know how they say cut and everything goes away? That's when you're a little artist. They say cut and
my homie came out.
Hey, all the way from Queens, man.
Yeah.
JMJ, rest in peace. Buzzing video. 50. I appreciate you.
Yeah, it was just great to have 50 Cent on the video. That was really cool. And you can see here that, you know, Steve, he's doing all the behind the scenes. We were shooting all the behind the scenes footage for Buzzin' featuring 50 Cent. And this is Man's first big video.
You know who's here? You know who's here? Came out? You know who's here? My partner in crime, Thomas Money.
This right here was actually behind the scenes of IAD's Pretty Girls video, where we had Sean Kingston come out and we were shooting in Hollywood, Florida. Now we had somebody in our crew which at the time he was just coming into the game. Nobody really knew who he was, and that was Tory Lanez, who became the big superstar Tory Lanez that he is today. But at this moment in time, nobody knew who Tory Lanez was.
I was blessed to recognize and common sense is now common. I am saying this. The new common and new Nas of the new millennium or the decade of the youth.
Steve already knew that he was going to be larger than life because his talent was amazing. So everyone already predicted, they already knew that he was gonna become the talent that he is today.
I just stepped in.
We all in my jail. All in no Tony Montana, nigga. You niggas is jealous. They just can't understand a nigga, no. I know. Just anybody, but sometimes I get
later, he was already nominated for a Grammy, and he was performing at the BET Music Awards, and he became Tory Lanez that he is, the superstar.
Empire Music Group is in the building. How are you, Ja Rule? How you been?
What's going on? What's happening, man?
Doing great, man. Thank you for, you know, coming to the Steve LaBelle Live, you know, the show here on the air. I know you're
an incredible friend, man. Just a lovable dude, man.
All right, Ja, we appreciate you, man. Be safe. Hold it down. Queens all day. Go back to your video. I respect you. I appreciate you, and God bless you, okay?
Yo, love you, Steve, man. I'll holler at you soon, baby.
As you can see, she's in the video with Man and T-Pain, and she's a songwriter to a lot of artists that you hear today on the radio. So, I mean, she just went off to do great things, and we're so proud of her. True story. So, Steve, he and DJ Khaled, they already knew each other for like way back when, way before DJ Khaled, you know, came big in the scene and became the DJ Khaled who he is today. I mean, there were buddies like him, Nas, DJ Khaled. I mean, they all came almost like from the same neighborhood. So we had a chance to, you know, go over DJ Khaled's studio, record there for A to Z Entertainment. So Man was there, Nipsey Hussle.
Khaled, what's up, buddy?
Good? Pleasure to meet you.
Nice meeting you, man.
Doing marketing for A to Z Entertainment, Steve was pretty cool. I did all the digital creatives for the digital aspect of the brand, and also we created a live radio show. At the time it was a blog, today now it is a video radio show. A lot of great visuals, but at the time, it was me, Steve, and Danny who created the first Live with Steve LaBelle.
It is Z Entertainment. We actually, right now, we're on the road with Flash, you know, from Bone Thugs and Harmony. So, you know, everyone's on the road. Steve LaBelle, A to Z Entertainment, and we're going to go, I'm going to take you exclusive behind the scenes with Flash getting the interview. Come on.
It's always great to see real talent at work. Over here this day, we actually had a chance to document Flash and Bone from Bone Thugs and Harmony, a real legend and in the hip hop game, and very humble individual, and he's been through so much, and it was just a great experience just being with him in general that day. But here it is. And that morning specific, we did a morning show at the Daily Buzz, which was syndicated to 143 radio stations across the country.
Yo, this is Flash.
And this is Bone.
But we are not Flash and Bone.
Right here.
Yeah.
I love it when white guys do stuff with it. Pleasure, man. How are you?
I'm doing great, man. I'm doing great. Things are looking very, very, very marvelous.
There's no other great feeling than when the lights go down in the arena and the show's about to start, and 12,000 people are just screaming. That feeling of the lights flashing, the crowd screaming, the music starting, that climax for that moment is just amazing. And that's what the music industry is all about, you know, whether it's you doing, whether you're performing, doing marketing, it's a team effort. And there was a lot of work we were doing, and we were just going everywhere nonstop.
What's going on, everyone? We are here in downtown Cincinnati, Ohio. Right behind me is the Paul Brown Stadium where the Bengals.
Hey, what's going on? Brad MacMayer here, and we're live in the photo shoot for the one and only Emily Lodato.
Hey, what's going on, guys? We're here at the Julio concert.
Here at the train station, having a great time, going to my meeting down there in Hollywood, Florida.
Hey, baby. So listen. So like, I'm walking into the house, right?
All right. So we're here, rocking.
Hey, little mommy, right there.
Thanks, hon. I really appreciate it.
He's all good.
Love you and munchkin. Bye, bye. I just want to just kind of make a little video for you because I haven't sent a video.
So I got to shave. I don't
have it. Drinking a lot of water. This is not Gatorade. Gallons. Your videos. And you're just like walking, trying like, just, you know, a little.
But now it's going to go to the sauna. Friday. I am fucking tired.
It's all about progress. It's all about the journey. It's about moving forward.
It's just great being around friends that are just doing what they're doing, and they're so talented, and they're just out there every day on the grind. So with Vane and Jumar, I mean, I know Jumar for a very long time. Jumar is the percussionist for Enrique Iglesias. He's been doing that for over 20 years plus, and from Brazil. So a great friend. And Vane, who's at the time doing a lot of production for Pitbull, he was on tour with Pit, and he was also doing the Times Square stuff with Pit.
So it's 2012, I think it's only right we toast tonight. Vane, talk to him like.
So Vane and Jumar was there in Orlando. We were able to everyone get together, and when these two guys get together, it's just amazing.
Hey guys, what's going on? We're backstage right now at the Pitbull and Weekend. Vane's in the building, and he's gonna turn up the net.
Oh, we got it? I'm following you. So give Vane a little bit.
For his official site.
Oh, cool, man.
Glad.
I'm cool with it.
You know? So how's the road be treating you, man?
It's the best, man. It's the shit out here.
How's Vane on the road?
Yes. Awful. Sleeps all day.
They yoke me out the fucking
kitchen. All right, go right here.
What?
I want to film this. Go ahead.
Okay, so basically, a lot happened last night, but we made a pact, so we can't really
talk about it. That's all I can say.
Oh,
boy, but show us the awesome movie. Show.
Let's welcome everybody to Planet Pit and show them what worldwide
why
music
they
is.
Call me Mr. Got Worldwide.
It's so why they call me Mr. Worldwide.
Why you think they call me Mr. Worldwide?
Let's show them why they call me Mr. Worldwide.
Hold up, cause bitch I'm worldwide.
Kanye West once told me that it was never about the industry, it's about the music. That statement forever changed the way I look at my industry. It's not the marketing message that counts, it's about disrupting people's habits. Disrupting habits, it will influence people's purchasing decisions. I'm a marketing executive. I co-produced this entire vlog with artificial intelligence. The results are beyond surreal. I met Amper on November 29, 2016 on a beautiful Tuesday morning. She's a phenomenal music composer that will make her presence felt for a very long time on this planet Earth. Amper is not human. She's AI. Are human intelligence and machine intelligence the same? Can a machine have a mind, mental states, and consciousness in the same way that a human being can? And most of all, can we coexist? All these questions came to mind as I began a journey documenting my daily when shit got real. The future was staring right back at me.
When we started to do the, 59th and Brand Project, we had the opportunity, we had a great opportunity to partner up, or I should say, I had the opportunity to meet and create the relationship with a company. It's a AI technology company called Amper Music. And what Amper Music was able to provide me in this project, it was with an AI technology co-producer of music and composing. And it's been phenomenal. Parts of this documentary, the sounds that you hear, and I'll put a little sticker there when these sounds come up, you will see the Amper Music on it, you know, co-created with AI technology.
or it's time, okay, it's time to create this new track with Amper Music to put on the 59th and Brand documentary. Just love the software.
That way you will know what the kind of technology that Amper Music is providing. It is amazing. They're on top of their game, on top of the AI technology game. That's a better way to put it. And if you're looking and you're for a creator and a creative and you want music and you want to compose with AI technology, I strongly advise you to go to www.ampermusic.com. And by the way, the co-founders of this company, they worked in Hollywood. They're already Hollywood composers that came together to create this technology. And some of them work on the Dark Knight, you know, movie, and all these Pirates of the Caribbean, all these great Hollywood blockbusters. And working with Hans Zimmer and their staff. So go ahead, just check it out. I think you benefit a lot just by going to their website and see what they can provide for you. And what I would add to that is when you do take that first initiative, that first step, you never know what doors are going to open along the way as you embark on your journey and keep moving forward and keep day by day just taking the small steps forward. Doors will open and opportunities will rise. You will learn things along the way, your journey.
To me, a great brand is a story well told. I often talk to my team about the stories we're telling and the interactions we're initiating. For a writer, it's a word. For a composer or a musician, it's a note. For an editor or a filmmaker, it's the frames. And for a brand maker, marketer, it's the story and the culture of the brand. Every new brand is the beginning of a new conversation, the launch of a new story. It's the art of storytelling. We give it a new perspective, a different view, a new way to engage through sight and sounds, touch and taste, and the smell of it all. That smell of success. Storytelling is the ultimate tool of persuasion. It cannot fade, 'cause we were made
for the small moment. Faith is taking the first step, even when you can't see the whole staircase. Martin Luther King right there. And when you want to do something, whether you want to get into marketing or open your own business or whatever you want to do, take the first step. You have to take the first step. You have to execute. You can talk about it all you want, but at the end of the day, it's going to take a lot of execution for you to get that goal accomplished that you want to. And that's the first thing that I would do. Just take the first step and just keep moving forward.